After watching Alien Covenant, many viewers had an impression that David killed Shaw to experiment on her just like he did with her boyfriend in Prometheus. I had the same impression after seeing her body in David's workshop and a sketch of her vivisected head. However, some details from the Prologue promo in Alien Covenant do not perfectly align with the idea that David killed Elizabeth to experiment with her body. Why would he make a tombstone with her name? Why would he hold her in such a high esteem as if she was his mother?
I never experienced such compassion. Certainly not from Mr. Wayland, or from any human.
All these hints suggest that the story between David and Dr. Shaw is more complicated than it seems. The theory in this video explains how all of these details can perfectly align in one cohesive story. But remember, this is just a theory, and if we'll get any answers to what exactly happened to Shaw, it would probably be in Alien Awakening. First of all, because of a manufacturing error or a cognition breakdown, David has adopted his own ideas about right and wrong and eventually developed human emotions. For this reason, David and Dr. Shaw formed a strong emotional bond after the events in Prometheus. Shaw has evident compassion for David. Despite the fact that David is an artificial person, Shaw seems to care for him and help him as if he was a real human being. David remarks in the voiceover that no one had ever shown him such compassion, especially Mr. Wayland or any other human for that matter. This line of dialogue hints to us that David was raised in a very cold environment. This would likely have been the cause for his sarcastic and cold attitude towards the crew of the Prometheus. David remarks to Shaw that she has a very kind heart and seems to interact with Shaw, showing equal compassion and affection once his head is reattached. Some people may argue that it was all done just to gain her trust, but there is not a single reason David would do it. He doesn't need Shaw to fly the juggernauts. He doesn't need her to understand engineers. That is why David's feelings to Elizabeth are genuine. At one point in the prologue, we see David holding up a picture he has just drawn of Elizabeth. The expression on David's face is one of a young child who is proud of a new accomplishment. These scenes suggest that David loved Shaw as much as an android could. She was an idealized example of humanity, compassionate, fearless, and searching. She was the exception. Having a genuine affection to Shaw, David wouldn't kill her, so let's discuss how she actually died. When David is putting Shaw in a cryosleep, if you look closely, you can actually notice that Elizabeth is sick. Her face is sweaty and she has a blanket around her body. In fact, it's pretty obvious that Shaw was infected by a tiny amount of the black goo when the trilobite was removed. When the trilobite ripped the uterus, amniotic fluids that probably had a tiny amount of the black goo got inside Elizabeth's body. Because the amount of the black goo was very small, or the black goo was not in its pure form, it took more time for Shaw to get sick. Another trilobite started to grow inside of Elizabeth, which made her sick a few days later. As discussed earlier, David loved Shaw, and since she always wanted to have a child, she viewed David as her own son after recreating him again by putting him back together. In the same manner, David viewed Shaw as a mother figure, so when she got sick, David put her in a cryosleep to keep her alive until the arrival to the paradise. When David was alone, he studied the engineer ways and probably discovered their evil nature, that it's so similar to most of the humans, but not to Dr. Shaw. David has developed a protective attitude towards Shaw. The desire to revenge Elizabeth and protect her from any dangers on the Paradise Planet pushes David to destroy engineers. While he was doing that, his tone is that of aggression, obsession, and vengeance. Once the planet is clean, David starts to experiment with the black goo and engineer bodies in order to find a way to save infected Elizabeth. David conducts hundreds of experiments to save someone he views as a mother figure, but nothing seems to work the way he wants. David realizes that he cannot keep her alive in the state of a human. That's why he decides to transform her into something completely different. A hybrid of a human and a xenomorph, but not exactly the alien queen that we see in Aliens of 1986. When David begins to operate Shaw, he finds many trilobite embryos inside of her. Inspired by neomorphs resulted from the black goo infecting the engineers and the biology of trilobites, David is able to perfect the design and create the facehuggers and the alien eggs. Apparently, Shaw couldn't survive the operation, and her vivisected body is a result of David trying to bring her back to life. However, through the alien eggs, David accomplished her ultimate desire of having children. And since all alien eggs contain Shaw's DNA, David believes that she will live on forever. Then, in the memory of Elizabeth Shaw, David makes a tombstone with her name as a tribute to her creation and legacy. Let me know what you think about this theory in the comments, like the video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe to my channel for more content.